Hi friends, good morning. My name is Vikramjit and in this video we are going to talk about what is slash boot partition and what will happen if all the content of the slash boot partition gone delete and how we can recover that content and how we can fix the issue. So first of all, it is necessary to understand what is slash boot partition. Slash boot partition is a Linux partition that contains all the information about booting process like grub information, kernel information, grub.conf file, which all are necessary in order to boot the system. So what will happen if all the content of the slash boot gonna delete? Here I'm going to show you what are the contents are available in slash boot partition. Here you can see that there are files and directories are there, kernel file, grub file, initrd file, vm lines file. So what will happen if all the content gonna delete? So here I'm going to create a scenario where I'm going to delete all the content of the slash boot partition and we will see how we can fix that issue. So now you can see that all the content has been deleted and I am going to reboot the system to show you what error message you will get if all the content are deleted. So it will take a couple of minutes to show you the error. Okay, fine. Here you can see that it is saying grub loading stage 1.5, error 15. Now we are going to fix that error. Let's see. So first of all, we have to boot the system in the rescue mode, and to boot the system in rescue mode we must have installation media so that we can attach the media. Okay, so right now I'm using rshell 5, so I have rshell 5 media and we will boot the system in the rescue mode from here. Restart guest. Okay, so now type here Linux rescue to boot the system in the rescue mode. And now here it will show some couple of settings that we have to understand and we have to take decision according to our requirement. Choose a language, English, keyboard type US, and networking. If you want to enable the networking on your network interface, then you can choose yes and assign the IP accordingly. And if you don't want to set any IP, then choose no and then continue. If you like my video, please don't forget to subscribe my channel so that you can get all the new video. So right now it is saying that my system has been mounted under slash mnt slash sysimage. We have to run this command. Here you can see that I have 3 or 4 mount point and it is showing slash mnt runtime slash mnt sysimage slash mnt sysimage slash boot. Means my all the partition, my all the mount point is mounted under slash mnt slash sysimage. So we have to make it normally by running this command. Now if you will see, you will get properly 2 mount point and which are mounted on slash and slash boot. So now we have to mount the DVD media so that we can install 3 packages that will help us to boot the system in the good mode. I'm going to mount the CD or DVD in /mnt and go to /mnt. There will be a directory like server. All the packages are available in server. So from here we have to install three packages. First one is kernel, second one is grub, and third one is redhat logo. I kernel. So I am going to install kernel. So right now it is saying that the package is already installed. So we have to use --force parameter to install the packages forcefully. Kernel has been installed. And after that we have installed grub package. We will search for the package in server directory and then we will install accordingly. Here we can search for grub. Okay, this is the package. And then we can install grub. --force, and then last one is redhat logo that we have to search. Redhat logo. Okay, good. So all the three packages has been installed. Now we will see, is there anything showing in boot? Yes, now we get some information like init rd, vm lines and some other configuration files are available in /boot partition after installing all the three packages. So here now one thing we have to do, that is we have to install the grub. Initially we just installed the grub packages. Now we have to install the grub. So grub install is the command that we can use to install the grub, and /dev/sda is my partition, my hard disk on which the grub will be placed, will be installed. It will take some time to install the grub on /dev/sda. Okay, fine, it's done. Let's rerun it once again to make sure it is properly installed. Okay, fine. Now one step is that we have to create grub.conf file manually. So here I'm going to create grub file. Default value will be 0. Timeout will be 5, or you can give 3 or 2, 4. Splash image HD0. Grub splash image okay. Title redhat, enterprise Linux, If you have any doubt, you can see which version you are running. You can run uname-a. Okay, so right now I'm having 2.6.18.5.3. Like this. HD 0 and then 0 once again. Kernel information. Beam lines. And then in RD. So this is my grub.conf file that we created manually, and now let's verify its configuration once again. Default value 0, timer 5, splash image HD 0, grub splash. Here is something is wrong. Splash dot xpm dot zz and then header menu. Title redhat enterprise Linux root HD 0 kernel VM lines. Yep, it's good. So now we are going to exit from this rescue, and before exiting from here we have to detach the CD or media. Now our system should come up normally without any error, and now once again it will take some time. Okay, yep, it seems that now we are good and our system is coming normally. Okay, fine, now our system is up. So now if you feel that my video is good and it can help you in production environment or in your home lab, please like my video and subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching my video. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye bye.